Exception. There is an exception to the throttle control rule. Wide open top gear turns. Turn 1 at Brainerd International Raceway is a perfect example. You come into it after 1 mile of straightaway. On a current 600 or 750 production or 250 GP bike, the turn is taken with the throttle wide open. What can you do? You can't roll on the throttle because it's already full on. What happens if you're halfway or two-thirds of the way through a wide open turn and you roll off and on? You go wide right now. The bike bounces around and is not stable. This is one of the most challenging and fun turns in America. On a 250 GP bike, it is taken at 13 grand in sixth gear or about 159 miles per hour at the entrance. An interesting side note, how would you gear your bike for turn 1 at Brainerd? Would you have it reach peak RPM at the end of the straight? A normal gearing goal? Not on a 600, 750, or 250. Once you lean the bike over, it will pick up about 500 more RPM because you're running on a part of the tire which has a smaller diameter, effectively lowering the gear ratio. So, if you geared for the straightaway, you'd be bouncing off the rev limiter at the entrance to the corner and the bike would not be near 40-60 weight distribution. The solution is to reach the 40-60 goal with the gearing instead of the throttle. If you geared the bike to run 500 or so RPM lower than normal at the end of the straight, the engine will continue to pull once you're in the turn and the bike will hold the line perfectly. Fine point? The above is, at first glance, a very fine point of riding, but it actually contains a practical lesson for every turn. Remember that leaning into a corner effectively lowers the gear ratio. If you downshift too many times and put the engine into too high an RPM range at the turn entry point, the moment you lean over, you could be stuck on the rev limiter instead of pulling through the corner smoothly. The bike will, of course, slow down from the cornering force and wind drag in any turn, and at Brainerd, you have to downshift at the exit of turn 1 to keep the revs up. The point is not to be stuck on the rev limiter mid-turn. Along these same lines, you may glance at the tack, while still leaned over, coming off a long sweeper onto a straight, see the tack needle at the red line, and think, it's time to upshift. It isn't. Because as you stand it up onto the larger diameter center of the tire, the revs will then go down. If you upshift too early, especially on a 250 GP bike, the bike won't pull strongly and you'll have to wait for the engine to build RPM. An ultra fine point is gearing a 500 GP bike so that it runs into the rev limiter on purpose at the turn exit. In this case, the rider is spinning the tire and allows the rev limiter to cut in so the wheel spin does not become excessive and wind up high-siding him. The power tapers off smoothly and the rider can leave it on the rev limiter for a moment with no ill effects. The only drawback is having to shift before the bike is totally vertical. How's that for precision bike setup and riding? Other exceptions. There are a few other specific turns that do not follow the rule, mainly because of bumps and/or mid-turn off-camber changes and radius changes, and they are downhill. The carousel at Sears Point and Road America are perfect examples. You do have to stop the throttle action, not roll off, for a moment or two, or you will simply be going too fast and too wide at the exit where the roll-on is most important. Power line. The power characteristics of your bike and the suspension settings have much to do with your line. On a 500 GP bike, you may drop some cornering speed to use the acceleration. On a 125 GP bike, you can't sacrifice cornering speed for anything. If its suspension makes the bike a little slow to turn, you'll have to wait longer to stand it up and be easy with the gas mid-turn to avoid running wide. Perhaps you've noticed some riders standing the bike up rather quickly towards turn end, whereas others allow the bike to arc through and come up gradually. Slow steering might be the answer as to why. So might the fact that the rider is a bit greedy with the gas earlier in the turn and has to keep the bike leaned over to stay on the track. He may just like to do it that way. Of course, the quicker the bike is stood up, the less resistance you have from the cornering forces and the faster you accelerate. Doug says, starting the real acceleration too early will make you have to readjust your turn and lose time. The end. Let's clear something up. Where does a turn end? Each turn has an exact point where it ends. That point is different for each rider and each bike. Definition. Where you can do anything with the gas you want to, where you are brave again, where your attention is free from the turn, where you are sure you can do it better next time, that's the end. The important point? There is a choice in lines, but they all follow the throttle rule. Donnie Green. The track surface is the same for everyone on a race course. The best riders just adapt quicker. With problem areas, you have to come up with a plan or a solution so you don't become stuck in anything. Mainly, you just handle the survival reactions and that covers it. I get a good mental picture of myself in every turn to get a starting point, then go out and do it. I use the same mental image picture to get an idea of what the bike should be doing, as well as what I should be doing as an ideal for the turn. There is a time to think about it and a time to do it. Throttle control. Chapter 5. Get it on. If good throttle control is responsible for good cornering control, that is, suspension in best range, tires delivering optimum traction, line predictable, etc., when would you like it to start? In what part of the turn should you have all these good things happening? Exactly when do you get it on? Street lazy. Street riders generally wait until about two-thirds of the way through a turn before they roll the throttle on. Under normal, low-speed, or urban traffic situations, a motorcycle does not seem to mind if you coast through turns. Most new riders take to this coasting technique like a duck to water because it does not trigger the in-too-fast or going-too-wide survival reactions. Under more spirited cornering conditions, all the positive results of good, standard throttle control are reversed while off the gas and decelerating.